I'm Dr. Karen Hildebrand with AWS.
I'm Andy McKee with Deloitte, and this is My Architecture.
So Andy, can you tell me a little bit about what Deloitte is doing in banking?
Absolutely. So Deloitte is traditionally known as a professional services company, but in the last 5 years, we've really transitioned into products. And one of the gaps in the market we saw was, how do we help banks and financial services institutions scale into the cloud and support them on that journey? And Converge Banking by Deloitte is our platform to do that.
So you brought your architecture along today. Let's take a look at it.
Absolutely. So at the core of our platform is EKS or Kubernetes. And for us, that's a really important tool to allow us to scale the platform and maintain our services. We then link that with API Gateway as our front door for our applications, and Cognito for our customer identity and access management, and MSK for all of our streaming. So anytime we change anything in the platform, EKS events that out to MSK, and MSK ultimately feeds our downstream data lake. It does a lot of other things as well, but that's one of the core capabilities. We also use Amazon Cognito as our customer identity and access management platform. Gives us a really scalable and flexible customer identity platform. And we back that with Lambda to provide customizations on top of Cognito.
So tell me a little bit about why you selected Cognito for a banking application. We often see that for identity management, user authentication, even customer experience. But it also has a strong backing in both security and audit and compliance measures. So tell me a little bit more about how that works best for your banking customers.
Absolutely. So if we take a step back a little bit and we actually talk about the use case for our customers, we provide the full set of transactional banking services for our customers from a mobile app experience right the way through to core banking. So for that, seamless but secure identity is really, really important. And we use Cognito to provide that. We worked with the AWS prototyping team to actually understand how we could deliver an easy to operate platform, which also met the regulations of the various geographies that we work in across the globe. And for that, actually, Cognito's ability to back onto Lambda was really, really key for us, because we can use Lambda during the token generation to configure how we manage step-up security, how we manage fraud integration with the platforms as well. And it gives us a lot of customization and flexibility, which we felt we weren't getting with other platforms.
Which makes a lot of sense. And it's really great to hear that you were able to work with the prototyping team in order to make sure that you had the most secure and regulatory compliant platform that as you were developing.
Yeah.
Can you tell me a little bit more about why you selected Amazon MSK and what that offloaded in this architecture overall?
Yeah, absolutely. As I called out, every mutation inside that Kubernetes cluster fires an event to Kafka. And that was really, really important to us as a modern architecture to give us the flexibility of rapid change. It allows us to subscribe back to those events in real time and build new capabilities at a very low cost. And that for us was really, really important. It also then provides us the ability to, using the shared responsibility model, offload a lot of our responsibility to AWS around patching, around maintenance, around upgrades, which we found traditionally when we ran Apache Kafka ourselves, it was a really high maintenance process and cost us a lot of time and money. So that's been really transformative for us.
So tell me then a little bit about how API Gateway is helping this overall architecture come together for the customer experience.
Absolutely. So obviously API Gateway seamlessly integrates with a lot of AWS services, particularly for us, how it integrates with Cognito to do our token validation is just so easy and so fast. That's been a real benefit of using the AWS ecosystem. It also provides the front door access to EKS and allows us to bring in a lot more capabilities around how we manage third-party developers, giving them developer portal access to the platform, which again just lowers our cost to build and cost to provide the services to our customers.
Well, that's a pretty significant benefit when you're also able to lower the cost of providing the service overall. Are there any other really fun things that you've learned as you've deployed in customer sites that have helped you understand how this scales or applies to multiple geographies?
Absolutely. Our customer base runs from all the way from small community banks in the US to tier one global financial institutions. And that's been a real challenge for us designing the architecture, because we've got to have the scale for those tier ones, but we've also got to optimize cost for the smaller community banks who might have 20, 30,000 customers. And then the tier ones might have 5-6 million concurrent users at a time. For us, that's why this architecture is so powerful. It elastically scales with demand and across geographies. AWS's regional footprint is the absolute highest amongst cloud providers. And that's been really helpful for us as we go to geographies where the regulations are very strict.
Thanks for sharing it with us today. We really appreciate your time.
No problem. Thank you very much.